Dr. Phil's at Bluefield's Wade Center. Find out why, coming up.
And see what celebrities recently made stops in the Mountain State, next on WMLT.
Welcome to WMLT. I'm Brian Arnold.
And I'm Rudy Rains. Around this time of the year, we usually find our minds wandering to family gatherings, presents, and that good food. But as the old saying goes, it's better to give than to receive. Recently, Dr. Phil and his wife Robin made a special trip to southern West Virginia to help spread that giving cheer. Brian Arnold has more.
Talk show host Dr. Phil McGraw and his wife Robin, the spokespeople for the Toys for Tots Foundation, are beginning their national drive here at Bluefield's The Wade Center.
What could be considered a momentous occasion for both the Wade Center and the city of Bluefield was also historic for the Marine Corps Toys for Tots Foundation as the event began its 60th year in operation.
You know, the United States Marine Corps has put so much love and energy into it, and they've asked us to be associated in the last few years, and we're really proud to be a part of it. And we thought no place better to kick that off than right here at the Wade Center in Bluefield, West Virginia.
To Dr. Phil and Robin, the Toys for Tots mission is one worth celebrating.
Toys for Tots has been around for 60 years for a reason. It's a needed program. It is such an efficient program of getting toys in the hands of the children. And when you hand them a toy, you hand them a message of hope.
Area children weren't the only beneficiaries of Dr. Phil's visit to Bluefield. The Wade Center itself received a helping hand as well.
The biggest thing that he did for us was to put musical instruments in our music room. He gave us 40 Fender guitars, 20 acoustic and 20 electric, and then six Casio keyboards. That was a tremendous gift to us. One of his sponsors, Renewzit, bought us a 15-passenger van, brand new. So it was a great day, and his visit certainly has impacted our ministry here in a powerful way.
It is that spirit of giving that has kept Toys for Tots alive for 60 years and is important to remember during this holiday season.
If anybody's watching and listening to this, cough up a toy, cough up some money, because we got some kids that are in need.
With generous donations to both the children and Wade Center itself, Dr. Phil's kickoff of the Toys for Tots drive was a great success. For WMLT in Bluefield, I'm Brian Arnold.
One Mercer County town is doing its best to brighten your holidays. Since 1997, the Bluefield, West Virginia Department of Parks and Recreation has turned the Tony Letito City Park into a winter wonderland. This showcase of Christmas spirit features over 600,000 lights and covers over 40 acres of parkland. This holiday tradition grows more popular every holiday season and is sure to live on for many years to come. If you'd like to see this festive Christmas display, it's open until the first week of January from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m. weekdays and 6 p.m. to 11 p.m. on weekends.
Everyone has their own traditions when this time of year rolls around. Some like to stick with the same old, while others decide to try something just a little different. We talked to a few Concord students to see what their plans were for the 2007 holiday.
Well, my plans for winter break, I'm mostly just going to go hunting, spend time with the family, hopefully get some cool presents over Christmas, but it'll be very nice. But I've already got one interesting present for Christmas. I ended up getting an HDTV already from my wife.
Hang out with people, friends and stuff, and work.
My winter break plans are to play music and Christmas shop as much as possible.
Concord students are also giving back this holiday season by sponsoring a child from the Angel Tree. Jeremy Halstead has more on how these children's holiday is looking a little bit merrier.
The holidays are the time of year when, along with Christmas trees, donation bins begin springing up everywhere. The Concord campus is no exception. There are a multitude of charity drives going on across campus. On the first floor of the Student Center, there are collection baskets for the Salvation Army's canned food drive. Across from the baskets, there is also a Salvation Army Angel Tree.
We have about 50 gifts so far in that range. Now, we probably have, of those 50 gifts, maybe about 25 or 30 kids are covered, because some people have bought more than one gift for a child. We have about 100 of the angels. I would say that we'll probably end up with somewhere a couple hundred gifts.
All 100 angels have been removed from the tree, and with faculty and students participating, over 50 gifts have been donated already.
Along with the Salvation Army, the campus sponsors some of its own events for the children and families in the community.
Student Affairs office had a party this morning, and everyone brought either a gift or canned goods for a charity. I believe they're going to a different charity than Salvation Army, but they'll go to a charity. On Saturday night, this Saturday night at 7 o'clock up in the ballroom, we have our annual Christmas party for the area kids. So kids that are under 11 years old can come and they can put together arts and crafts, have Christmas cookies, we may have some Christmas games and things like that.
I was able to find one of the students that made a donation to the Angel Tree.
Well, I've always been taught, like, throughout my growing up years, I guess you would say, that you're supposed to help other people, especially those that don't have things, so.
If you are planning on making a donation, the cutoff date for both drives is December 12th. For WMLT News, I'm Jeremy Halstead.
Coming up after the break, we'll see how Concord students are preparing for those dreaded finals.
And we'll see what new additions are in the future for the Campus Beautiful.
Welcome back to WMLT. Before college students can relax and enjoy their Christmas breaks, they have to go through that 1 week they dread the whole semester. Yes, finals are upon us. Angie Coons took a closer look at how Concord students are handling the stress of finals week.
Final exams are quickly approaching here at Concord, and students are rushing to the library to prepare themselves for these tests. Some students told me how they were feeling about the upcoming exams.
But I'm trying to study really hard, but I'm trying to balance work, a social life, school, you know, normal student things.
This is a time you'll find most students studying profusely in the library.
Well, I guess everybody kind of sort of is nervous about it. I mean, everybody wants to pass and get their classes out of the way.
For many students, finals require a lot more time and attention than most assignments throughout the semester. It can be a very stressful time, but is rewarded with the follow-up of winter break. The WMLT would like to wish good luck to all Concord students on finals for the fall of 2007. I'm Angie Coons, reporting in Athens.
New additions have been popping up all over campus this semester, and the coming semesters don't look any different. Recently, a new third-story addition was proposed for the J. Marsh Library, and the library isn't the only one that's going to see a transition soon. The old cafeteria in North Towers will soon be converted into a brand new weight room. The space has been vacant for quite some time, but it will finally house fitness equipment to benefit all students. Sprinklers will be installed no later than January 2009, and those will cost $1.3 million, along with a laser smoke detector that will cost $50,000. Students will not have to pay a fee, though, to use the center because it will be included with their student fees.
Communication on the campus is now more convenient than ever. Concord University recently set up a text messaging alert system online, which can alert Concord students, faculty, and staff about emergencies. Many students have cell phones, so anybody who has subscribed to the online service can receive the alert in seconds. The system sends messages about police emergencies, non-police notices such as parking lot closings, and alerts about university closings and delays due to inclement weather.
Cookies and other sweets are being sold this week for just a quarter. The Reflex Magazine Committee is attempting to raise money for the upcoming spring edition.
It's completely produced by the students here. All student works, art pieces, literature pieces, poetry, you name it. It's a little bit of everything, and we're basically just running this bake sale to get money to cover the printing costs for now.
The Full Collar magazine will be available at no cost towards the end of next semester.
One other celebrity recently made a big appearance in Charleston, West Virginia. Glendale native Brad Paisley returned home for one big night to entertain everyone in the capital city. Rudy Raines was on hand to take in the CMA Male Vocalist of the Year's commanding performance.
You may recognize him for his amazing singing talents that won him the 2007 CMA Male Vocalist of the Year Award, or maybe his crazy music videos. But one thing's for sure, Brad Paisley is nothing short of a complete entertainer. The Glendale, West Virginia native has made himself into a country superstar, and November 30th, he returned to his home state to showcase his superstar talents.
All right, well, we're heading for Charleston for the Brad Paisley concert. Hop on in and let's get going.
The Civic Center was nearly sold out with fans from all around the state, including Concord student Chris McGraw. The show started strong with former American Idol Kelly Pickler. And Rodney Atkins kept the crowd singing along with his growing resume of hits. But everyone was there for Brad, and he didn't disappoint. With a 16-song set plus an encore, Brad Paisley brought the house down with his amazing light show and guitar and singing talents. I got a chance to talk to Brad and ask him if it was a big change playing in his home state. He said, "Yeah, it's always different, but it's always great." But whether he was slowing it down or keeping the crowd jumping, Brad Paisley is definitely a West Virginian that knows how to get a little mud on the tires. Rudy Raines, WMLT News, Charleston.
And we're going to leave you today with a little clip of our video that won Rudy backstage passes to meet Brad Paisley.
And this is our last show of the semester, so have a great holiday, and we'll see you next year. Enjoy the video. Space.